Welcome friends, welcome to my channel, IRS Production. Today we are going to discuss about a topic, how to crack an interview. Basically, if you are lucky enough, if you are fortunate enough, you will be selected for either government job interview or a private job interview. But the question patterns, the questions what they ask, the criteria on which they measure you, or the things what they want to know from you remains the same. So today we will be discussing about the main two questions which they ask in any of the companies, any of the interviews, any of the jobs. So taking the first, that will be the define yourself or introduce yourself. This will be the first question what they may ask. How will you deal with this question? First of all, you have to make a list of the items which you need to say much prior to the interview. You have to select a list. What are the items you need to tell them? So you cannot like directly say go over there and just face the interview. You have to be prepared for that. You may have to take a note down of the things. You may have to go near the mirror and do a practice of the things so that you will be like fluent enough to tell the things. So what are the things which you will be discussing on such scenarios is the first you will be telling about yourself, that is your name. Second thing, what you are currently doing. For example, if you are doing BTech, then you will be saying like, I am currently pursuing a BTech degree from such and such college. Whatever you are doing, maybe a diploma or any other courses which you are doing, you will be telling about that. Third comes your high school, from where you have passed the high school. Fourth, you will be telling about, you will be showing your gratefulness, that is the gratitude towards your parents. You will be showing that how my parents are involved or how their role is so crucial for the upliftment or the upbringing of myself, so that I am in a position to be sitting in front of you and giving this interview. The whole credit goes to them because they have involved themselves, they have invested a lot of money, lot of their time, so that you will be able to come up to here to make you capable of these things. Fourth, you will be telling about the knack of the technology. For example, if you are going to face any IT interviews, definitely you should mention about something that is related to you, that what you have done your internship, maybe it's a training or something. You will be taking the knacks. For example, I have a knack for UI development, I have a knack for robotics, for for automation developments, or you may say about artificial intelligence, machine learning, whatever you have done, whatever you think this is good, you may tell about these things. One more important thing is the hobby. They want to hear that what are you having interest in. So don't overestimate or underestimate them, because the person who is sitting in front of you almost knows all the things because they have crossed your age, right? So you have to be honest. Don't say that I am a voracious reader where you don't read any novels or something, because that will put a negative impact. So what you need to do, if you are a real reader, then only you say that I read books, I like novels, or I like traveling. Because the next questions may be a tricky question, and come from that, because they may ask, which novel are you currently reading, what are the past novels you have read, what are your future plans. These things may come up. So whatever answer you are giving, you have to be giving in a tricky manner, so that the next questions and the next followed up will be in the alignment you want, you decide. So you have to discuss these things, but make sure this should not cross a 2 minutes boundary, because no one is having that much of time to sit and listen to you for continuous hours long. So make sure it is 2 minutes duration. The second questions which may come, and which will definitely come in some of the different formats, is what is your strength, what is your weakness, or they may ask you give you a SWOT analysis, or they may ask you why should I hire you, why are you fit for the company. These may are the different types of questions, but the answer will be the same. That is a SWOT analysis. SWOT stands for four words, SWOT. So what is the meaning of SWOT? That is a strength, weakness, opportunity, and threats. What is the strengths? First of all, you have to make a list of the things which you are good at. For example, if you are good at the technological skills, you have a very good communications skill, you are a very good persuasive, you have that persuasive skill, or anything which you are good at. For example, you are a very good coder, developer, tester, planner, whatever. You are a very good in the requirement gathering or analysis phase. So you will be telling that in your strength part, that these things which is already in the corporate world, and I have acquired this knowledge, or this I have already done. If you are experienced, if you are a fresher, then you will say that by the time of the education, I have forced myself to learn these things as a part of, so that I can join the company which I am being applying for. Second comes the weakness. You always have to remember, this weakness is actually not the weakness they want to hear for. Actually, only they have 2 or 3 minutes of time to interact with you. They never know you, and neither do you know them. Okay. So what is the thing over here? That you have to you have to show yourself, you have to sell yourself in such a manner that their mind will be like blown off. Okay, this is the candidate I should hire. He is the perfect fit for my company. Like, they should be thinking like that. For that, what you have to tell the weakness is actually not the honest answer. You have to give us some diplomatic answer over here. For example, you may say that I am quite focused into my work. Whenever I am getting into the work, unless and until it is done, I am not able to leave that work, not able to switch to any other thing. Actually, what it is showing, that it is showing your weakness, that I am not able to switch to other works or not able to do other works when I am focused into one works. But what that strike in their mind, that this guy is very dedicated, this guy is very like, he is totally focused into the work, he knows, he has the devotion, dedication and determination to excel into that work. That message will be thrown to him. Third comes the opportunity. In opportunity, what will you decide, what will you tell them is like, the whatever the things which has come into your life, whatever the opportunity has strike you, you have made the best of it. For example, you got into an essay writing, into something, whatever the speeches or anything which has occurred to you, which has come to you, suppose a seminar on the technology things or anything, which you got a chance, and even whenever you got the chance, how you have taken it, how you have converted, how you have converted the difficulty into your opportunities, so that how you face those type of stresses, challenges, how you have overcome those things and how you have converted those things into a positive strength into your life. So always you have to throw them that this is the positive vibe which should come out from the body, not your negative sense. Always remember that there are two things which you have to do. That is the first of till, you have to sell yourself. Second, there should be a business flavor coming from each and every line whatever you are seeing, because they will hire to get a monetary benefit. So you have to like term or coin everything in sense of the positive vibes. The next comes the threat. What are the threats? The threats are the challenges which may happen right now or which may happen in the future. You don't know. For example, monetary crisis. For example, something related to the parental issues, or something like a stress, mental stress, emotional stress, or whatever physical stress may happen. So these are the threats which may come, and you have to give them a solid proof that I have a management already. I have managed these things already. If such scenarios comes, how will I overcome that? How will I do what the things are needed so that I can overcome from that situation? That they want to hear. If such situation comes to, suppose after 2 months they ask you to go abroad and you don't want, because or your parents are your like liabilities or as a whatever you feel like, your parents are all dependent upon you, you can say I cannot go to US, UK or wherever they want to send you. So that comes a drawback to you. So you have to be adaptable, flexible to take the job. So you have to tell that I am adaptable, flexible. I have some backup plans. If in such scenarios, since I will keep my mother and father to my kith and kin's places, or someone places who will be taking good care of, so that I can do manage both the things. So actually that was a threat, but you have converted into a positive vibe. So what they want is your positive feelings from about yourself. So this was it, guys. These are the two very important questions which comes in almost all the interviews. So you have to crack the interviews. All the best for your future, and you will definitely do it. Thank you. Bye-bye.